There is nothing I love more than pumping up the volume in the TVNZ newsroom just after five and getting right into an episode of The Chase.
Yeah, and when other people are trying to work, that can be a little bit annoying.
Yeah, well, this is a very good show, though, and I know our audience are big fans of The Chase. In fact, two-thirds of you watch it, which is why when I heard my favourite chaser, Paul, the Sinnerman Sinha, was coming to the country, I knew we had to get him on the couch.
As far as chasers go, Paul Sinha's hardly an imposing figure. At just over 1.7 metres, he's one of the shorter of the chasing stock. But what he lacks in legs, he makes up for in quick wit.
Unbelievable!
Other than that, I didn't really know the answer to that question.
The Sinnerman's a born performer. The former doctor threw in the stethoscope in the late 90s and took up stand-up comedy with a little quizzing on the side.
I've recently downloaded that new smartphone app that gives you the location of all the single middle-aged Asian men in your area. It's called Uber.
But he's here for the laughs.
Paul Sinha, it's great to have you with us. What brings you to New Zealand?
Well, work, funnily enough, even though I live thousands of miles away, I've been a lot of people that watch me on The Chase don't necessarily know that I've been a professional stand-up comedian for donkey's years now. And I've never had the good fortune to be invited to New Zealand to perform comedy. And then in September, I kept hearing rumours that The Chase was really big in New Zealand. And then I was approached by a complete stranger, the Museum of Modern Art in New York, who said, "Are you the Sinnerman?" And I said, in a New Zealand accent that I can't do, and I said, "Yep." And she said, "You are very big in Auckland." And I thought at that point, I need to come to Auckland and do stand-up comedy. So here I am.
Are you carrying security with you around the streets of New Zealand? Because you may be mobbed.
Well, I have wandered on the streets of New Zealand. I've walked down the K Road and down Ponsonby today, and I was not mobbed in any way, shape or form. There's a guy called Nick who runs a vegan bakery in St Kevin's Arcade. He recognised me. Hello, Nick. And a middle-aged Asian chemist recognised me. But other than that, I remained entirely unmolested.
So. Well, I suspect you'll be up for one or two selfies. The Chase is huge in New Zealand, but I suspect a lot of people won't know about you too, that in a former life, you were a GP. This is quite a career change.
Yeah, it goes GP to comedy to chaser. That's the order of play. I come from a medical family. I was very much pushed into a subject that I had very little aptitude or particular interest in, to be perfectly honest with you. And I dreamed a dream that one day I'd be able to move away from the profession. And in 2007, I had enough gigs booked in my diary to go, do you know what? I'm going to take the plunge.
So, if it's part of the family, being a doctor, how did your family take it when you said, I'm sorry, I'm going to be a full-time comedian?
Not great until The Chase came along. It's with Asian families, it's all about bragging rights. And as soon as The Chase came along, they suddenly didn't tell people their son's the comedian. They said their son is that guy that you see on telly. And suddenly they had bragging rights over all of their Asian friends. And it was a very different set of circumstances. They're really proud.
So what's your Achilles heel? What subject do you really not want to come up?
Well, rugby union, the works of Peter Jackson, the films of Jane Campion. Things like that. The Olympic shot put title.
Okay, so your comedy here is not going to be quiz-based?
There are lots of stuff about being a minor celebrity. There's lots of stuff about the reality of being on The Chase. But it's not really stuff about general knowledge as such. It's more life stories.
Paul, I think a lot of people want to know this, particularly Chase fans. Are you paid on your performance, whether you win or lose on The Chase?
We get paid exactly the same whether we win or lose. And the thing is, when we lose, we are devastated. But the producers are absolutely delighted because losing makes great TV. So, you know, we're not going to get paid more when we win, because actually, at a certain level, they want us to lose. They want us to unexpectedly lose as well.
Just before you go, congratulations. We understand you got engaged earlier in the year too. Would you like to have a new New Zealand wedding?
Well, we've booked the wedding, sadly, but proud to say that I'm engaged to the 11th ranked quizzer in the United Kingdom. So we are very much the sort of Kanye and Kim of the United Kingdom quizzing circuit, which is a nice place to be.
Keeping it in the family.
Yeah, I imagine the dinner conversations there. Paul, thank you so much for your time.
No worries.
It's lovely to have you on the show.
Thank you very much.